Okay, now I told you, as I told you earlier, for the record 4, that is 179 and 68, we have computed the new centroid value 169 and 58. Now I am going to find the distance for the fourth record. Fourth record is 179 and 68. I am going to find the difference for this record from cluster K1, which is 185 and 72, and cluster K2, which is 169 and 58. So 179, the same process I am following. I get from cluster K1 difference is 6.32, from cluster K2 is 14.14. That means the fourth row will belong to cluster K1 since the difference is low. Okay, so that is why K1 I have added 1 and 4. Now again, what happens, you have to recompute the cluster for K1, because the centroid for K1, because now you have added a new value, the fourth row is being added to the cluster K1. So we have to recompute the centroid for K1, just as how we did for K2 over here. Okay, and then again compute the distance from the fifth row and the new K1 value. So this way we repeat the process until all the rows are completed and we get the two clusters as K1 and K2. These are the rows, okay, and which they belong to the two clusters. So this is how we apply your K-means algorithm to find to which cluster the different data members belong to. Okay, I hope it is clear to all the students. Thank you.